can't believe that you got me in a suit and tie. I had to take a pull so I wouldn't cry. You got a line out the church door saying goodbye. Yeah, I believe them when they say you're in a better place. You had a wild side, but you had amazing grace. I know you're way off up in them clouds, but if you could still hear me right now, I hope you hit those ghost streets on two wheels. I hope your mansion in the sky's got a 10-acre field with some mud and some hubs you can lock in. Make some thunder, make them wonder how you got in. Hide your beer, hide your clear from a man upstairs. Crank it loud, hold it down till I get there. And when I do, I hope you got some new stories to tell. Till then, give heaven some hell. We'll be right back.
gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see
not go alone, for part of us went with you the day God called you home. God looked around his garden and he found an empty place. Then he looked down upon the earth and he saw your precious face. He put his arms around you and he lifted you to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best. Yes, he always takes the best. We knew that you were suffering. We knew you were in pain. We knew you'd never get well on this earth again. So he closed your weary eyes and he whispered, peace be thine. Then he took you up to heaven, so gentle and so kind. God looked around his garden, and he found an empty place. Then he looked down upon the earth, and he saw your precious face. He put his arms around you, and he lifted you to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best. Oh, God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best.
Stepped in and saved the day. But once again, I say amen, and it's still raining. But as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. And I'll praise you in this storm, and I will lift my hands, for you are who you are, no matter where I am. And every tear I've cried, you hold in your hand. You never left my side. I will praise you in the storm. I remember when I stumbled in the wind. You heard my cry to you and raised me up again. But my strength is almost gone. How can I carry on if I can't find you? But as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. I'll praise you in this storm.
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, well, God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
Guess I'm mad at things that don't matter way too much. I let the way back winds and my old friends scatter like they were dust. I get to chasing that rainbow particle riding through the pouring rain with nothing to show for it, standing there soaking wet. Looking up, shaking my fist as the thunder rolls. Now and then on nights like this, I catch a thunderbolt. I wanna live a life like a dollar in the clock on the wall. Don't only shine a light like mama's front porch when I'm lost and lonely. Stop the giving and start forgetting. Be somebody that's worth remembering. Live a life so when I die, there's
standing room only, standing room.
Take my grudges and my old regrets and let them go. I wanna learn how to say a lot more yes and a lot less no.
Girl, I wanna dance and shout and love out loud and come alive. Don't wanna be the guy too cool to laugh and too scared to cry. I wanna live a life like a dollar in the clock. Front porch when I'm lost and lonely. Stop forgiving and start forgetting. Be somebody that's worth remembering. Live a life so when I die, there's standing room only, standing room only.
Stop judging my life by my possessions. Start thinking about how many headlights will be in my procession. I wanna live a life like a dollar and the clock on the wall don't own me. Shine a light like mama's front porch when I'm lost and lonely. Start forgiving and start forgetting. Be somebody that's worth remembering. Live a life so when I die, there's standing room only, standing room only. Standing room only, standing room only. Standing room only, standing room only.
boundless grace, the God of age.
came the morning that sealed the promise. Your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, yours is the victory. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name. Jesus Christ, my living hope. And hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Oh God, you are my living
hope. I don't know why God always takes the good ones first. And man, I've tried to be strong and carry on, but damn, this hurts. And I just wish that I could talk to you again somehow, someway. Even if it's for a moment, so I can hear you say, don't cry for me, I'm alright. I'm better than you know. And this life can be short ride, so don't waste it on sorrow. Just hold on to those moments and the memories we share. We're both headed for the same place anyway. I just beat you there. I know they say, just give it a little time, you'll be okay. That might be true, it don't really help me today. And we ain't supposed to question the man upstairs. There's just so much I don't understand. It just don't seem fair.
Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome each one of you here to this funeral service for Rick. On behalf of Sherry, Aiden, and Sarah, Bev, and Ron, and the rest of the family, thank you for coming out and showing your support for the family and for Rick's friends. My name is James Peters, and I have known Rick since he was about 1.5 years old when he became part of the Fair family, which is about 39 years ago. My family and Rick's family attended the same church in the village of Rhineland. And I remember Rick coming to Sunday school I remember Sunday school picnics, church picnics, and Rick would bring his RC cars along, and I think Johnny had just as much fun with them as Rick did. But I remember being able to play with them as well and try them out. And so, we'd have our memories. My memories of Rick go back a long ways. And there was a time where my wife and I were youth group leaders, and Rick was part of the youth group. And so that was a privilege to have him there. And when Rick was in his teens, and I think he was already racing motorcycles, but I think he was trying to get into racing cars. And I had an old 1980 Cordoba for sale, a beige one. Some of you might remember that one. He came and bought that from me, and I asked him what he wanted with it. And he says, oh, it's for a field car to have a little fun with. And I think he had a fair bit of fun with it, because a while later I asked him, he says, well, it doesn't work quite so well anymore. And then when he and Sherry got engaged, they bought the house that we lived in at that time. The house they lived in Rhineland, and that's where they lived until they moved to the farm. And so it's been a privilege, and I've been blessed to know Rick all these years. And so I extend my condolences again to you, Sherry, and Aiden, and Sarah, and the rest of the family as we mourn the loss of a friend, of a husband, a father, a son, and we just want to do that together today. Today is not an easy day because death is an intrusion. It's an intrusion in life. We were created for life, and yet death is now part of our equation, part of our life, because of disobedience to God. Life here on this side of eternity has a beginning and an end, and we often refer to this as the cycle of life. However, for the Christian, for the child of God, time spent here on earth is just the beginning of life. Once our time on earth is done, the Christian steps into a new reality of being face to face with Jesus. In 1 Corinthians 13:12, we read, now we see but a poor reflection, as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. And in 2 Corinthians 5, we read these words, therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. We live by faith, not by sight. Rick now sees clearly what eternity holds for him. He now sees Jesus by sight, the one who saved his soul and gave him eternal life. I would also like to share a few verses that bring comfort to those of us who are left behind to mourn and to continue life without Rick. Psalm 23, verse 4 says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. God is with us in this time. And the reason there's only a shadow in the valley of death is because God's light is still there. Death casts a dark, dim shadow. But God's presence, God's light, is there with us and gives us strength and comfort in the midst of traveling through this valley. And then in Hebrews 13, we have this promise from God. Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. So we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. This promise is first given to Joshua when he took over the leadership of Israel. And God knew Joshua would need this promise to go through all that lay before him. He had a tough job, a tough road before him. And likewise today, God says to those of us who are mourning, I am the Lord. I am your helper. Do not be afraid. Rely on me, and I will walk with you through this valley. So in the midst of this dark and shadowy time, God is with you. He will walk with you. He will protect you. And so I invite you to allow him, to allow God to do it for you. Open yourself up to his love and peace in the midst of your grief. Allow God to comfort you with his presence. Please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, this afternoon we thank you that you are here with us. We thank you that you never leave nor forsake us, but you walk with us through the trials of life. You walk with us through the joys of life. And as we were together with the family yesterday evening, we talked about some of those joys and some of those trials. And Lord, we saw that you were faithful in and through all of them. Thank you, Lord, for your presence here. May you guide and direct us. May all that is said and done here be to your honor and glory. And Father, we thank you for the loved ones that mean so much to us. Thank you for all who have come to support the family. Pray that you would encourage each one to continue that support, to continue to connect with and to meet with Sherry and Aiden and the rest of the family. Thank you, Lord, for the confidence that we have in you because of your promise of eternal life, because of your provision of life through Jesus. And so, Father, may your Spirit give comfort to the grieving hearts today, and may we experience your love in a special way this afternoon. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, we will have a congregational song, which Lydia will come lead for us. And after that, Aiden will come up to share the obituary and the tribute.
First song this afternoon, a congregational song, is I'll Fly Away. These songs have been chosen by the family. If you're able, please stand with us to sing.
Rick was born on May 26, 1983. He was the only child of John and Sarah Fair, who loved and raised him on their family farm near Shine Bays, Manitoba. Farming became Rick's life at a very young age, and he eventually took over the farm after John's health declined. When John and Sarah moved to Winkler in 2010, Rick, Sherry, and Aiden moved into the homestead. Rick married his best friend and life partner, Cherise Hamm, in 2003. They were blessed by the arrival of their only son, Aiden, in 2005. Together, Rick, Sherry, and Aiden and their three employees worked tirelessly to ensure the farm produced well. In 2020, Rick was diagnosed with a rare type of cancer that was affecting his liver. This was very difficult recovery for Rick. He had to learn to slow down, which wasn't easy on him, the go-getter that he was. The cancer reared its ugly head again in April of 2023. This time, it was in his small intestines. Once again, he underwent surgery to remove all but six inches of the intestines. They were not able to get all the cancer. Complications set in, and Rick was hospitalized at Boundary Trails Health Center. He was baptized upon confession of his faith on August 10th, 2023, by Pastor Larry Reimer. On August 15th, 2023, Rick went to be with his Heavenly Father. Rick was predeceased by his father, John, in April of 2022. He is survived by his wife of 20 years, Charisse Neham, one son, Aiden, mom, Sarah Nee Gerbrandt, parents-in-law, Ron and Bev Ham, sister and brother-in-law, Stacey and Jay Cron, nephew, Peyton, and niece, Braley. Special thanks to Dr. Visser of HSC, HSC staff, Dr. Gekutan, Kaylee Vauden, Dr. Welk, Boundary Trails Health Center staff, and the large medical team of professionals who worked with the family, Weeb's Funeral Home, pastoral team, and the abundance of prayers and support from all. Forty years ago, a very special little boy came into this world. He found his loving home with his parents, John and Sarah Fair, who raised him on their family farm. Rick was a very active child who was never really afraid to try anything. He loved the mechanics of machinery, snowmobiling, dirt biking, race biking, and dirt track racing, to name a few of the things he excelled at. Anything Rick put his mind to, he mastered. In 1993, a blonde beauty caught Rick's eye. Sherry became his wife and best friend in 2003. Oh, the adventures they had together, never a dull moment. In 2005, another very special little boy came into this world. Aiden was just like Rick as a young child, also not afraid to try anything. Rick and Sherry farmed along with John and Sarah for all their married life. Aiden recently joined the family team, so their whole family built the farm to what it is today. Rick loved to work. Rick also had some interesting hobbies. He dreamt up something and would create it, much to the delight and amusement of everyone. He called Jake one evening to work on something, not saying what, and when Jake got there, the two of them created a pneumatic hammer, just for the sheer entertainment value. He also designed and created a cannon from an anhydrous tank. Test run, shot a soccer ball quite the distance. His next victim was going to be a bowling ball. Rick was never one to sit still. Boredom was not in his vocabulary. If there was ever a lull in activity, Rick would sit and plan his next escapade, so he was dubbed Peter Planner. If it ever got too quiet, he would squawk like a bird to break the silence. He had a healthy obsession with roosters, just not the real ones. He did have a live one for about a day before it had to go. Rick impacted everyone he met with his amazing personality, quick wit, sense of humor, and genuine, kind, loving heart. Rick could make a whole room laugh just because he had an infectious laugh with a great sense of humor. Rick was never a fighter until 3 years ago when he entered the fight of his life. He was diagnosed with cholangiocarcinoma, a rare form of cancer that affects the whole body with no remission or cure. He had half his liver removed due to the cancer, and that was a very difficult road to travel, but only the first one he would have to endure. Life changed drastically for the family. Anyone who knew Rick knew that he and Sherry lived their life in a very big way. They put together a bucket list, peeling off as many things as humanly possible, like buying a limo for crop checking, getting a milkman outfit, and was seriously looking into getting a milk truck to complete the ensemble, flying in a helicopter in BC Mountains, a trip last summer to Red Lake where he got to ride along in a floater plane and got a tour of a gold mine. He got to pet a live giraffe in Mexico, another thing on his list. One thing most people don't know about Rick is that he loved the greenhouse. Come spring, he was super bummed if Sherry wouldn't go to look at the flowers with him. He loved to pick the flowers and garden plants with her. His favorite color of flower was purple. Rick's second battle with the cancerous beast happened, and he fought like a gladiator. But so sadly, he was ravaged, and it took him away from us too soon. His battles are over, and we are left to go on with the biggest hole in our lives. We will see him again as he sports his healthy new self. See you later, Rick. We love you.
troubles and heartaches are vanished away, then we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. So many places of beauty we long to see here below, but time and treasures have kept us from making plans, as you know. But come the morning of the rapture, together we'll stand anew while I stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and heartaches are vanished away. Then we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you.
Good afternoon. I'm Larry Reimer. I'm the hospital chaplain at Boundary Trails. I'm also the pastor of Cornerstone Vineyard Christian Fellowship in town here, and it's been my great privilege to be caring and walking alongside Rick and Sherry as they've encountered this not so normal thing for them to have happen to them. It's an amazing journey. I think the people who have gone through similar things before know the pain, know exactly what's attached to this. And so, especially with someone having this happen so young. And so we feel for you. Our condolences are with you. And my wife and my daughter send their condolences as well. Yeah, I did some searching around on the internet. I didn't know Rick all that well. I met him in the hospital 3 months ago. But from the first moment I met him, it was as if we could have been friends for a lifetime. And I'm sure that's a constant, and it's a consistent story in the room here. With anybody who met Rick, they knew he was a person who you could get along with right away. He wasn't hard to get to know. He was just really open, honest, and what you see is what you get, which is always a treat for me, because I tend to be that kind of person too, and I really enjoyed that about him. And so we got along well as soon as he came in. But I was searching on the internet, and so I was preparing for this message. What do you say at somebody's funeral if you don't know them that well? So I went to check up on his Facebook page. Sometimes that can be a risky thing. Sometimes that can be a fun thing. It was a lot more fun than risky for me. I just had a lot of laughs because I found out a lot about who Rick was. He was an adventurous guy. That anhydrous tank was crazy. I laughed so hard when I saw them shoot. Did you shoot a bowling ball? Was that an actual bowling ball, or was that a soccer ball that you shot across the field? It was a soccer ball. I was like, somebody's going to get injured. It ran for miles. It was unreal. Anyway, it was interesting to see a bit of his life. And I was sad afterwards because I wanted to know this guy more. But anyway, I went onto his Facebook page, and there are a few things that interested me. Some quotes that he, or a quote that he left on his page says here, Worry is a conversation you have with yourself about things you can't change. But prayer is a conversation you have with God about things that He can change. And this is something that became more real to him, I think, in the last little while as he was discovering a closer relationship with God. I went to the Urban Dictionary. That can be kind of scary sometimes because that place is a little bit risky with their definitions about things, but I wanted to find out what Rick's name meant in the Urban Dictionary. And this is the most respectable version of the definition I could share with you today. Richard, heart of gold. He is extremely kind and always compassionate, puts others first before himself, but still manages to have a thoughtful opinion and holds true to his beliefs. The best boyfriend a girl could ever ask for. Beautiful eyes, great body, fantastic hair, impeccably dressed, extremely intelligent. Knows how much knows much about the world and people around him. Could talk to him for hours about nothing. Very mature for his age. He knows what he wants and how to get it. Someone you will always want to have by your side. Your life will change once you meet him. Isn't that not true? That's true, eh? I also thought, I was looking, his race car number was number 921, am I right? So at 921, I love numbers. I don't know, numbers have fantastic meanings to them. And I'm not a worshiper of numbers, but I'm very interested in how numbers affect us in our lives. And the number 921 was his race car number. And I found out what that number means. People who like this number, 921, whatever life situations come about, they're likely to approach them with a creative point of view. Your dynamism and your charisma tends to make you a broadly likable person. Generally, social gatherings welcome you and your optimistic approach to personal interactions. Many find you an inspiring person. Much of your attention is on how you help humankind. And you tend to view things from a broad-minded, holistic point of view more than a narrow focus. Tolerance and kindness are part of your nature. Your philanthropic leanings go hand in hand with your benevolence. The relationships of people, nature, and physical environment, the coexistence of all is understandable to you. You thrive with companionship and associating with others. You tend to be a romantic. Personal independence to do and be according to your own preferences and decisions is an important aspect to your happiness. Alone time is cherished. That's interesting, hey? These are just numbers and just meanings of names, but don't they suit him? Like, to a T, right? This is the guy we know. And isn't it amazing how God places these characteristics in each one of us? Each one of us carries an identity that he gives us to benefit everyone else, right? He adds this into the mix of relationships. None of us are the same. Some are very different to spark other things in others differently. Rick was that kind of person. And I'm so thankful that I got the chance to meet him, to know him. But in the grand scheme of life, God uses all of these things to point to himself. The personality you have, the character that you have, what God has given to you points to him, because you were not spoken into this place by yourself. You were given life from the very voice of God, a word spoken into existence today. You are here because of God, because of him. And that, just knowing that that's your starting point, gives you great value and great honor. Everyone in this room has great value and great honor to God most of all, and then to each other. And we have this responsibility, this ability to give to others as we've been given, to give of ourselves to others, to be ready for any situation, right? I'm convinced of this truth, that God is always calling us to himself, trying to build his character into us so that we can face life's trials with his strength and character, not our own. He knows that what we face is not something that we can handle, and so he helps us when we allow him to. He makes us ready. But sometimes we don't realize the preparation until the new happenings in our life actually take place. In Luke 12:35-40, it says this: Be dressed, ready for service, and keep your lamps burning like servants waiting for their master to return from a wedding banquet, so that when he comes and knocks, they can immediately open the door for him. It will be good for those servants whose master finds them watching when he comes. Truly, I tell you, he will dress himself to serve, will make them recline at the table, and will give and will come and wait on them. It'll be good for those servants whose master finds them ready, even if he comes in the middle of the night or towards daybreak. But understand this, if the owner of the house had known the hour the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be ready, because the Son of Man will come in an hour when you do not expect him. There is nothing more tragic than when a beloved family member dies suddenly. And although we all know that death is a part of everyone's life, nothing can prepare us for the whirlwind of emotions when we are faced with this type of shocking news. Jesus calls death a thief, robbing us of something precious, either our own life or the life of someone we love. It comes unexpectedly and unannounced, leaving us shaken and vulnerable. Over the past few days, you have experienced the meaning of Jesus' words in a tragic and personal way through the death of Rick. You sit here still in shock and disbelief that he could have been taken from you so quickly. Your grief is further deepened by the sting of so much that was left unsaid and so much that was left undone in your lives together. Death has robbed you of so much in such a short time. But when we experience a significant loss, we are robbed of so much more than a husband, father, and friend. An unexpected loss robs us of our sense of security, our plans for the future, and even our joy in life. The fears and emotions you are feeling today are natural to those who lose a loved one so unexpectedly. It is natural to say, why him? Why me? Why now? After such shocking loss, it is natural for life to seem without direction and even without purpose. Death can rob us of so much. It can leave us broken and in tears, but despite its power, there are some things in life which death can never rob from us. First of all, death can never rob us of love. Throughout these past years, you built a relationship with Rick. He is part of many of your memories. The relationship of love survives death. Not only is Rick alive in your memories and alive in your heart, but he is alive in heaven. Through God's love and mercy, Rick looks down on you and prays for you. From the vantage point of heaven, he hears Jesus' wisdom about your heart and can know all the things that you wish you would have said to him. Is that amazing? Rick is still a very real part of your life. Even death cannot rob you of that. Secondly, for those with faith, death can never rob us of our hope. We hope that Rick is with God this day in heaven, rejoicing in the gift of everlasting life, which the Father promised him at his baptism and his conversion. And we hope that we will join Rick in that place of utter joy and happiness where death can no longer touch us. How can we be so confident in the face of such tragedy as you've experienced? Our faith and our hope are centered on Jesus Christ. He faced death on a cross out of love for us and out of hope that our Father would raise him again. In so doing, he showed us that faith, hope, and love are stronger than death. Amen. We now have courage because through Jesus' death, death has already been defeated. In Romans 8:28, it says this, "And we know that in all things God works for those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." God walks us through our pain and brings out his good as we press into his faithful heart to redeem even the most tragic situations that we face. Jesus says in John 14:27, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. and do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. As we rest in His peace, it brings us heavenly perspective in our difficult life circumstances. He gives like heaven gives. And what's heaven like? It's full of joy and peace and love. It gives in abundance, right? Heaven gives in abundance. Coping with the loss of a close friend or a family member may be one of the hardest challenges that many of us face. It's important to understand that the process of grieving does not follow a specific timeline or list of steps. There's no predetermined set way to grieve, and everyone relies on other different aspects of their life to move forward. We have our beliefs, our faith in God, and our hope for heaven, but these things may not instantly take our pain away. They may not make up for all the time we have lost with our loved ones, but they can give us perspective and confidence as we take the first steps in putting our lives back together. Today, we are taking the first steps towards healing and learning to cope with the tragic loss. Although no one can truly understand the pain you may be feeling, together we can make a statement by our presence here that our faith is something to say. Our faith has something to say about the experience, the unexpected loss you've experienced. Through Rick's death, and it was not unprepared for. The hope of everlasting life in heaven began to grow within his heart. Every prayer he said, every good thing he ever did, every sin he confessed and found forgiveness for, prepared him for this day when he would meet his Lord and God. He may not always have spoken of it. We may not have always been able to recognize it, but it was real. And we can believe that today God sees it and that God richly rewards his faith and his readiness to enter into the loving embrace of our Savior. In the final chapter of his life, Rick suffered a great deal. You, his friends and loved ones, were there every step of the way to hold his hand, to comfort him, and to wipe his tears. It may even be as a welcome relief that he suffers no more and now rests in the hands of a merciful God, safe from anything that can harm him. But his pain and suffering and eventual death could also have left questions in your mind. How can such a merciful, all-powerful God allow so much suffering? Can he really be good and all-powerful? These questions have been with the human race since the beginning of time. I cannot pretend to solve any of these questions to anybody's satisfaction. Our lives are complex. We very often have more questions than answers. Faith does not answer all of our questions. Instead, it gives us the assurance that God is present with us when we suffer. Up to the moment of our death, God is with you now as you suffer the loss of Rick, just as he was with Rick through his illness. Whether you feel relief or grief, God is with you, and you can be sure that he will never leave you in the difficult days ahead. Romans 5, verse 1 to 5 says this: Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith and to his grace in which we now stand. And we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance. Perseverance, character. And character, hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Faith assures us that your loved one now rests in the hands of a just and merciful God. You're sure of it. Otherwise, you would not be here. Your loved one was sure of it as well. That assurance gave him the strength to face his illness with courage and patience. It is the promise that he made to each of us at our conversion in the seed of everlasting life that was planted in our souls through our faith. It is a promise that God gave Rick when he came to know him in a new way. When Rick was baptized, he confessed that Jesus was his Lord. He was brought into the character of Christ, and he was obedient to Jesus. And as he professed Jesus as Lord, we poured water over his head in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Rick rests now in God's hands just as certainly as he rests in the memories of your heart. Faith, furthermore, assures us that God is not just a supreme being or an unmoved mover. This God is no mere philosophical abstraction. Rather, this God is the God of Jesus Christ, a personal God who knows and loves us. This God is the God who suffered death. He's not unmoved by the suffering and grief, but has felt and lived through it through his Son, Jesus Christ. Moreover, this God conquered death through Jesus' resurrection. Our gathering today is not only motivated by grief, but the faith-filled joy that through our conversion and obedience to Christ through baptism, we also arise from the dead and be reunited with our loved ones, where sin, suffering, and death can no longer touch us. In the face of death, with all its terrors, we can hold fast to the belief that God has conquered hell and that we will live forever. Can you imagine that? We will live forever. My mind is just blown away at that concept, forever. And I'll end with this scripture passage in Romans 6. Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism unto death, in order that just as Jesus was raised from the dead through the glory of our Father, we too may live a new life. For if we have been united with him in death like his, we will certainly also be united with him in a resurrection like his. What a great hope we have in him. What a great hope we have for Rick. Let's pray. Lord, I thank you for the great gift it is to be your child. And for the ones here that know you as Father, we ask you would comfort us. Everyone in the room, Holy Spirit, would you come and give comfort to your children today? Give wisdom and insight and revelation to our hearts of your great love for us, that we would come into agreement with your heart that cries out to us today, come to me, all you are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. So, Lord, we thank you that you give us this. This is the great promise of your heart, to give us the peace that we so desire in these difficult times. So we pray a blessing over the Fair family and over the Ham family. Lord, we ask, Father, for your hand to be on them, especially in these next few days, weeks, and months. Would you give them power to withstand, to stand in the midst of this thing? Would you give them insight and wisdom to come against any kind of discouragement that would take them into a discouraging path of destruction? Lord, we pray for protection over their hearts. We thank you that they have many friends and family that will come around them. Lord, spur us on as community to come around them, to support them. When we have a nudge in our hearts, would we be obedient to that nudge? Holy Spirit, come and empower our hearts to comfort and to care for these ones in these next days. We pray all these things in your name, Jesus. Amen. Bless you guys.
Our closing hymn is a favorite of many people. It talks about our Creator, Sustainer, and Redeemer, our Father God. How great thou art. Please stand with me to sing. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
So that brings us to the close of this funeral service for Rick. I have a few announcements. Memorial donations may be made in memory of Rick to Candlelighters Childhood Cancer or to South Central Cancer Resource. There will be a private family viewing right after the service, so I ask that you remain seated until the ushers come and usher you out. The interment will take place at Shaanvaes Cemetery immediately following the service. So for those of you who want to come to the burial, you can come out first when the ushers come and tell you, and then after that, those who want to stay, you can go downstairs and start with the FASPA. We'll have the table grace here before we leave. To go downstairs, there's a set of stairs through this exit here and to the north, and there's also one to the south and directly to the back. There's an elevator with a white door, so feel free to use that as well. The elevator will take you directly to the dining hall. So please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, as we have heard from your word this afternoon, we've been reminded that you care about us. You are involved in our lives. You don't place us here and then pull back and see what happens, but you are there waiting, and you are available for us to call on you and to walk with you and to ask you to lead and guide and direct. And I'm so grateful that you have created us for relationships with one another, and relationship with you. And so, Father, this afternoon as we go to the cemetery to put Rick's body to rest, I pray for strength, pray for the endurance that it will, that each one will need to do this, and we pray for safety as we travel there and we travel back. And Father, as we fellowship around tables, we pray for your guidance there as well, that as we fellowship with one another, as we eat together, as we converse together, that all that we say and do would be an encouragement to those around us, and of course would honor you. And Father, I now pray this blessing upon the people here. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Last night I had a crazy dream. Wish was granted just for me. It could be for anything. I didn't ask for money or imagine my. Sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still for one more day with you. First thing I do is pray for time to crawl. I'd unplug the telephone, keep the TV off. I'd hold you every second, say a million I love yous. That's what I do with one more day with you. One more day. Sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still for one more day with you. One more day, one more time. One more sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what it would do. Leave me wishing still one more day. Leave me wishing still one more day.
I know you're up in heaven, but damn, it hurts like hell. 'Cause I'd just be pretending if I said anything else. And I know God don't make mistakes, but This sure feels like one. That won't change the facts. That won't bring you back. So I'll cry 'cause it's over, and smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. Thank God for all the memories and pictures on my phone. They don't fill the empty, but I feel less alone. And I know you're with the angels, right where you belong. 'Cause you were one to us, you left a legacy of love. So I'll cry 'cause it's over, and smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. You lighten up a whole room like that. You made us think, made us feel, made us all laugh. You always giving that shirt off your back. I miss you bad. I'll cry 'cause it's over, smile because we had you. Packed a whole lot of living, even though it ended all too soon. And in time, I'll start healing. But even when I get that feeling, no matter where I go or what I do, I'll never not remember you. You, I'll never not remember you.
It's perfect outside, it's like God let me dial up the weather. Got the whole crew here, I ain't seen some of them in forever. It's one of those never forget it, better stop and take it in kind of scenes. Everything's just right, yeah, except for one thing. You should be here, standing with your arm around me here, and cutting up, cracking a cold beer. Saying cheers, hey y'all, it's sure been a good year. It's one of those moments that's got your name written all over it. And you know that if I had just one wish, it'd be that you didn't have to miss this. You should be here. You'd be taking way too many pictures on your.
should be